Hi everyone, welcome back to another episode of Roll for Initiative.
The weather's starting to get warmer, spring is just around the corner, and for many of us, springtime means love is in the air, and we're going to talk about how do we incorporate that love, romance, sex in your tabletop campaigns. It can be kind of a daunting topic, but we're not going to shy away from the real stuff here on Roll for Initiative. No sorry, Bob.
Incorporating romance and sex is kind of a little awkward at first, and it can be embarrassing, but it can add a lot to the campaign. Now, there's an excellent article on the site Gaming as Women that talks about introducing romance and sex into your system. And it breaks down kind of how to handle it and why you might want to introduce romance to the campaign. It is going to be a little embarrassing and possibly awkward at first, but if that's something that your players want to do, once you get past that first session, it's going to be a lot easier. As a player, introducing romance to the campaign adds another layer to how you play. It gives you another reason, instead of just, oh, I'm going off to run this mission, it might be, I'm going off to prove my love, to rescue somebody who I love, and adds that layer of relationships into the game. Or if you're playing a character that is a very flirty, sexual character, you definitely want to have romance involved in your campaigns so that it makes sense for your character. You know, somebody who's super flirty is going to flirt and probably might hook up with somebody in a tavern if they hit it off with the bar wench.
There's also two very different ways of dealing with romance and sex within your campaigns. One is a player interacting with an NPC. Maybe it's your character's wife or husband or love interest or mistress, what have you. Or there's the times where two player characters may be in an established relationship at the beginning of your campaign, or the characters end up developing feelings for each other throughout the session. Those two very different situations probably should be approached in slightly different ways. What is nice about the two articles on Gaming as Women talks about the different ways of approaching the relationship, and specifically approaching sex within the campaigns. It was really nice because it talked about the use of humor, the use of what kind of dealing with it as a, and then they fade to black. And there's not a need for most people and most campaigns to get into the nitty-gritty details of exactly what it was that's happening. Now, for those campaigns that are interested in getting extremely detailed, there are manuals and books out there for that sort of thing. It's pretty easy to find them online, as well as the physical hardback books, the complete book of carnal knowledge, and things like that. One of the people that we used to game with, he had an extensive collection of different books and manuals, and he had a couple that was dealing with sex and pregnancy and STDs in the sword and sorcery type world. Those aren't the kind of books that I necessarily need or I'm interested in or am going to pull from, but it's nice to know that they're out there in case you ever really do need to know what happens physically and the gestational period between a drow and a half-orc that end up getting pregnant together. There's a book out there to answer those questions.
Now, a couple of times in our Shadowrun campaign, I've actually dealt with my character has flirted with various NPCs, trying to get information out of them, trying to lure them off so that the other players can then tackle them once we're out into a, you know, deserted alley and we can drag them off and get the information we need from them. And the way that our GM has handled it is I make a couple of rolls and that establishes how well I flirt, how
the rapport between the character and the NPC.
Usually the first couple of lines of dialogue will get played out, and then we'll just make a roll so that we can kind of speed through the rest of it and not have my character flirting with an NPC for half an hour when it's just a, oh, you made a roll? Yep, they think you're pretty. They're gonna go flirt with you.
Dealing with the relationship aspect can sometimes be a little bit easier. It's just one more layer added onto the character, a romantic relationship or something like that, a marriage or a courtship for your characters. And often if that's done with an NPC, it's not quite as difficult. When it comes with interacting between two player characters, in my experience, it's always been something that is discussed between the two players, and it comes up, and it's usually done sort of as a third-party type thing. The characters let the GM know, we're doing this. This is happening with our characters. It's a way to explore the relationship without having to have the awkwardness or the potential awkwardness of two players, maybe they're friends, maybe they really only know each other because they game together, having to actually word it and role play out the different relationships. Maybe that's something that interests you and one of your other gaming members, and maybe it's not. For the most part, it's really all about finding what's comfortable and lets the story happen.
And I think having relationships within your group adds a new dynamic, even for the characters that aren't in that relationship. Because if you know that Ed is dating Sarah, you're going to talk to Ed differently about Sarah than if they weren't dating. You know, if you're concerned like, hey, Sarah's been taking a lot of risks recently, I'm concerned. If you know somebody's dating them, you're going to approach it differently because there's another layer to that relationship than just a friendship or work partner.
The different systems out there, sometimes they approach sex and relationships in different ways. The Pathfinder books, I haven't really found all that much on the topic, not that I've gone looking for it all that deeply. I know it's discussed a little bit in some of the old D&D books. The Exalted system has some of it in there. They're there, it's discussed, and it's often left up to the player and GM's discretion. Shadowrun talks very blatantly about it. In fact, in the 5th edition book, the title of the chapter is just called Sex. And the first line kind of from the authors, from Catalyst, is, we were going to call this relationships, but let's be honest. Nobody's dating and going to the malt shop in Shadowrun. It's about getting some. And that's fine, as long as kind of everyone knows what's going on. Honestly, for me, what I found as a player and in situations is really the use of humor and the use of euphemisms and fading to black. In one of my campaigns, my character had developed feelings for an NPC. It made for a really interesting relationship because they were all a part of a military. The NPC was their commanding officer. The addition of a complicated relationship and a sexual relationship added to the story and created some subplots, and it was really great. But in the campaign, when it came down to them actually having sex, I remember my GM simply said, all right, I'm not going to roleplay you having sex with another character. Your charisma score and the way you've been interacting, you get up to a room. If you really want some details, and I rolled a dexterity and a stamina check. Based off of those rules, the GM kind of laughed and said, it was pleasurable for everyone involved. The repercussions of the relationship, the things that grew out of it, were still there. It was fun, it was funny, and it was very not detailed, the actual act itself.
Now, I think it is important that you make sure that your group is comfortable with adding relationships, or if you want to go to as far as adding sex to the campaign, you need to make sure that everyone is okay with it. That adds enough of a new layer and something that some people just might not be comfortable with. And you want to make sure that everyone in your group is excited and happy to game and not coming going, I'm really nervous about this section. And maybe it's something of you ease into it. You go from, okay, they're just dating to getting married, adding that element to the story as well as to your party. But that's something that I think that everyone needs to be okay with that to add it in.
And there's no reason people shouldn't be okay with it. Your characters have relationships with each other. And in the real world, people have romantic and sexual relationships. There's no reason to shy away from adding it to your campaign. Just maybe have that conversation about it first. It can add a really wonderful and dynamic layer to the way all of the characters interact with each other as player characters and other people as NPCs.
Just like actual relationships, it's important to talk about it and be honest about what you want and what you're expecting.
And hey, just like the real world, the first time it might be a little awkward and not what you expect. But be willing to laugh at it, and the more you do it, the easier it'll become. So don't be shy. Everyone has their first time at some point. Thanks for joining us for this episode of Roll for Initiative. Please, in the comments below, we would love to hear what are some of the ways that you deal with relationships and or sex in your campaigns. Do you go with euphemisms, saying that the dashing rogue goes off with the bar maiden and they make the beast of two backs? Or do you use some of those books that are out there, giving real numerical values, having different kinds of checks, and potentially pregnancy and STDs and all kinds of other fun stuff that's out there as a consequence of their risky behavior? Let us know how you handle everything, because we love reading your responses.
On our next episode, I won't be here, but Ryan is going to be talking with a special guest about Shadowrun. Make sure to tune in, especially if you're interested in hearing more about the Sixth World.
So leave a comment below. We always like hearing what it is that you have to say on the topic that we bring you each week. We'll go through and read all of the different ideas, the ways that you handle love, romance, and sex and gaming. And everyone that comments on topic, we'll put them all in a big hat and draw one of those at random. And you get to win one of our very own miniatures that we've painted. We'll get information, whatnot, and send it off to you. So comment, share, like, and maybe you can get one of your very own minis that either Dawn and I have painted. Can't wait to see you next time on Roll for Initiative. I'm Ryan.
And I'm Dawn. Thanks for watching.
Bye.